My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble dribble, you know, riding in my Fiat. You really have to see it, 6'2" in a compact, no slack, but luckily the seats go back. I got it.
Daily Bitcoin updates and technical analysis. We track the price of Bitcoin as a proxy for the cryptocurrency markets at large. Today is August 1st, 2023. And we're starting the month off perfectly, okay? Bitcoin, altcoins, everything's green. It looks like we're going to get a quick move to the upside. I believe that Bitcoin is going to have a quick jump to 40K. Okay, and that altcoins are going to make a quick move up 50 to 80%, some 90, 100%. Okay, that's what we're going to talk about today. It's going to be a kind of a recap and an elaboration of the previous show where we were discussing upside targets. So guys, if that interests you, watch until the very end. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're well positioned to take advantage of this move that we've been waiting for so long. All right, let's get into it. So Bitcoin, let's start off with that. As per usual, you can see we've been in this heinous consolidation for about 40 days. Let's see where our tool is. Damn it, I never know where these tools are. I'm just guessing. Okay, this one. All right. So we can see here, this consolidation is 39 days, 40 days, okay? And it's been tough. It's been tough. With whether you're bullish or bearish, this sideways stuff is tough, okay? Very few, if anybody, is making money here, okay? And if they say they are, they're probably lying, because you're just getting chopped up here trying to trade this. The best thing to do in these situations is to position yourself. One, determine what you think this is. Is it accumulation or is it distribution? Meaning, is it going to channel then break up, or is it going to channel and break down? Position yourself accordingly, not necessarily trying to make a quick buck off of these little moves, right? So that's basically what I've been trying to do. I've thought that this was accumulation, right? Meaning this channel was more likely to break up than down. And we've come down to the absolute bottom of the channel and even wick below it, right? For what I've been saying is a spring, right? In Wyckoff accumulation, Wyckoff theory, we call that a spring. When you wick below the lowest perceivable support of the accumulation channel, only to come back, okay? And this is what we've got here. This nice W reversal pattern, okay? So, Bitcoin of 40K. Why 40K, Dean? Okay, here's why 40K. So, this is going to be me recapitulating what I said in the other show. 40K is likely only because this is, if this is 40 days of accumulation, that means that right there is 40 days of resistance. Now, one almost incontrovertible tenet or axiom of trading is, if you form staunch resistance, you're going to have to retest that resistance as support before moving on. You don't just break this and then continue. No. You're going to have to pull a move where you go up, you come back, retest that 40-day resistance as support, and then go. What's mostly compelling about that trade plan is the fact that it's not just these 40 days of accumulation, actually, because you have to take into account the fact that price also found this to be resistance all the way back in April, okay? So you're essentially talking about, you know, let's measure it really quickly. Guys, if you're getting value, please like, share, and subscribe. You're essentially talking about a 100-day level of resistance right here, okay, locally. And that's not even counting what else you may find if you look more left. But 50 days, 100 days, that being said, more likely than not, on the daily time frame, once you break 31,500 thereabouts, right, you're coming right back down, right? Not immediately, but after you hit a significant resistance, you're going to come back to retest it as support. And that's the trade plan. That's the theory. This is why I'm saying 40K. Now, why 40K specifically? Because it's what I'm saying. It is literally the, from what I observe, the next significant level of resistance. So how do I ascertain that? So I did this yesterday, or not yesterday, or the day before. Last time I talked about this. Two ways that we have confluence that 40K is it, all right? The first is if we take this double zigzag, this declension, as our move down, and then all of this stuff as an accumulation, what we can do is take our Fibonacci retracement tool from the top of this declension, right? Let's try that again. From the top of the declension, right, all the way down to the bottom, the orthodox low, okay? And what do you see? You see that the 0.618 buy ratio is the target, okay? And so, what do you know about buy ratios? 0.618 buy ratio, it's very, very important, okay? The golden mean, the golden ratio. And in charting, it's typically where price finds support or finds resistance, right? Finds resistance on the way up if it's below it, finds support if on the way down if it's above it. So we're below the 0.618 of this move right here. So it's likely that represents staunch support, and that's almost exactly at 40K. That's one of the reasons I believe 40K is a likely target for this move up, which should happen a lot faster than people think. And I've also talked about this because the nature of the move is completely different than anything we've experienced up until now, right here, right? Since the beginning of the year. Since the beginning of the year, we've been under staunch resistance. All of this is staunch resistance. So all of the price action, albeit positive, has been stymied by all of this resistance right here, and then all of this resistance right here. Do you see? You're in a minefield of resistance, but once you get out here, okay, above that 31,000 resistance level, then you start to fly. So I think that's going to catch a lot of people by surprise. Okay, that's number one. Number two, really quickly, the target of this bullish reversal pattern, this inverse head and shoulders, okay, I believe that gives you 40K as well. Let's see. Let's try. Okay, let's make this a solid line. And then superimpose it from the side of breakout. That here-ish. Yeah. So do you see that? You have confluence there. That's what we call confluence. We have two different ways of ascertaining a target. And they both give you the same target. So this mauve band should be our target. So 40K. And the other reason, actually, there's a third reason. The third reason I like 40K is if you do hit 40K, and let's say our impulse, it's likely starting from here, right? You measure the impulse from the bottom of the move to the top of the move. You see that the retracement would come down to the golden pocket, or at worst case scenario, come down to the 786. So you're in this sweet zone of, you know, I don't know what you call it, the golden pocket. Some people call it 0.5. I like to call it 0.5 to 618 the golden pocket, but some people refer to the 0.5 Fibonacci retracement all the way down to the 786 Fibonacci retracement as the golden pocket. Okay, and you do get that golden pocket retracement if you measure a move up from here, right? Do you see that? So that's my reasons for why 40K specifically, okay? And I don't think that should take that long. Also, I may, or I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the fact that given that it was August, it is August 1st, and we did experience a drawdown, a decently significant drawdown today, right? We went all the way down to 28.5. I would say that that may have been the full moon drawdown, right? Which you typically get, right? Remember, in a full moon, you typically experience a local market bottom 0 to 3 days after the full moon. Today was the full moon. We came, we made a bottom at 28.5. So that may have been the full moon bottom. So we should expect a positive move, at least from the standpoint of the lunar cycle, to take us to the next lunar phase, which is the new moon, which is the local market top, which should be 2 weeks from now, right? So around the 14th, the 15th of August, okay? And then you do the same thing in reverse, right? Because then you have another new moon or full moon at the end of the month. So August should probably look something like this, perhaps, right? August 1st to 30th. I don't know how many days are in August. Something like this, right? Where we reach a local market top on August 14th, 15th, thereabouts, and then come back down for the new moon towards the end of the month. Maybe. I don't know. It's a trade plan. It's something to look out for. Now, why is all of this, what catalyzes all of this? As always, it's the US dollar currency index, okay? The DXY has been pumping like a scam coin for God knows how long. And it's not a real pump, but it's been moving, it's been trudging up and to the right for far too long, okay? You can see here, after that whole Fed hike, you can see it's chopping up, and finally, it looks like it's hit some significant resistance where you're getting a significant start of a move down, okay? And again, we're completely overbought on our momentum indicators. If you go to the daily time frame, you can see the daily is completely overbought. The 4-hourly is completely overbought, coming down finally. The hourly, it's finally in oversold territory. 15-minute oversold territory. It may stay that way just because we've been coming up on the DXY, right, in this move for about 2 weeks, right? 2 weeks. So that's a significantly long time, okay? So I can expect, just based off of that, 2 weeks of prosperity, right? If this indeed is an impulse, and it's looking strong, it's looking true, it's looking believable that this is indeed an impulse. Let's have a quick look at altcoins and call it a show. And, you know, first thing I want to say is, if you look at your distribution lists or your watch lists, you should see a decent amount of green, which is very encouraging. And some strong daily candles, very encouraging. Strong daily candles, given that the daily candle has just opened, right? Look at Dodo, for instance, right? DYDX, very strong moves, right? This is what you love to see. And again, generally speaking, let's talk generally for altcoins, since, you know, this is we're not going to talk about every single last specific altcoin. Let's just look at the total two really quickly. Generally speaking, my targets are still the same, right? So again, you see this inverse head and shoulders, bullish reversal pattern, right? Pop out, retest of the neckline. That hasn't changed. That trade plan is still valid. And if we do move from here, it's quite simple. It's a target of, well, initial target of the inverse head and shoulders, right? That's your initial target right there, whatever that is. Let's see. So that's probably your first wave, yeah? Okay, so that makes sense, yeah? This resistance right here has proven to be a staunch resistance. The neckline of this massive pattern, okay? So that's your first resistance. You probably do a 618 retrace there, and then you continue, and that's your next likely target up there. Again, that's going to be the height of this bullish reversal pattern, superimposed from the site of breakout all the way up here. So that's pretty much it, guys. I think we are finally moving. Bitcoin of 40K, altcoins, first to here, right? And next, eventually, all the way up here. Okay? Hope this was helpful. Hope this was useful. Like, share, and subscribe if you got value. And perhaps I will see you tomorrow. Take care.
You'll do time for the crime of Les Majestic and the police, because they can't arrest me.
I like to see you wiggle, it makes me dribble. Fancy a fiddle?
My money don't jiggle jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle wiggle, for sure. It makes me want to dribble dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it. 6 feet 2 in a compact, no slack.